I can rope after him. I've got everything else taken care of. I don't really need him. Back 20, 30 years ago, things were not that way. Can I be honest with you? Listen, I didn't know God at the time, but I needed God.
Yeah.
If someone would just help me find God, see? And the problem was I was around a bunch of Christians. Even when I moved up here from Colorado back in 1980, there was a lot of so-called Christians in the school. And you know what? I was never confronted about anything about my faith or what I believed in or about Jesus. No one talked to me about Jesus. Nobody did.
Come on.
Right.
You know why? There's a bunch of reasons why. I probably wasn't a Baptist. I probably wasn't, you know, this color or that color. I didn't fit in, guys. I had long hair. I had earrings. I had knee-high moccasins. I was a weirdo coming into South Carolina. I was not like everyone else.
Come on.
But you know where I hung out with? You know where I was accepted by people who didn't care who I was?
That's right.
The drug addicts.
Yeah.
Hello?
That's
it's
right.
Not weird. Their drug addicts accepted me. Their drug addicts talked to me and told me about all kinds of things. Whether it was right or wrong, I didn't care. I just wanted someone to hang out with, amen?
Come on.
But I'm telling you the truth, there was a bunch of Christians that never came up to me. Not one.
That's right.
Now I'm going to wonder why.
They don't either.
You know, the only one that ever talked to me about Jesus was my grandma. And she had to come from Colorado just to talk to me. Because no one else would. Isn't that crazy? How God would send somebody 2,100 miles, Dennis, just so that they could get a word from the Lord, amen? And then she'd be gone after 2-3 days. And she'd be gone for months. And then she'd come in again, and I'd be someplace else, all tore up and racked up. I wouldn't even know where I was at, but my grandma would find me every time, and she would be sowing seeds in my life.
Amen.
You know? It was weird, guys. I understand what God's heart is. He wants you to get to know Him in hopes that you might grow after Him. Because that's when life is going to change. Amen?
Amen.
Are you sick and tired of being sick and tired?
Amen.
I am.
Amen.
You know, we've been prophesying for the last 3 or 4 weeks about a breakthrough. And I think the breakthrough is here. Because I'm living evidence even today.
Amen. Okay? Come on.
But maybe the breakthrough
that's right.
hasn't come for you yet because you're still needing to grow after Him. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You need to trust in the Lord with what?
All your heart.
All your heart. You see? That's when things will start changing.
Yeah.
Okay? He'll make a way when there isn't any other way.
Definitely.
Okay?
That make knows Him.
Last verse. Go to Isaiah 62.
Man, come on.
Thank you, Lord. Isaiah 62. Guys are there, say amen.
Amen.
Look at verse number 10. Lord says this, go through. Say it, go through.
Go through.
Is that a verb? Miss Liz, is that a word? Is that a verb?
Sure.
Go through. Is that a verb? Help me out with my English. I'm not.
I'll go yes.
Yes. Thank you. It is a verb, right? So it must mean action, right? Okay, go through. This is what was being told me yesterday. Okay, that I wasn't going through. I was just standing at the gate, but I would not go through. The Lord says today, go through. Go through. He doesn't say it once, He says it twice. So that must be pretty important, right? He just doesn't say it one time, he says it twice. So the first time I must not be hearing correctly, but the second time he's going to enforce it, right? Go through the gate. Right? You guys need to have some faith. Amen? Go through the gate. Prepare the way. You guys see that again? Haven't we been preaching that for the last couple months? Prepare the way for the Lord, right? John the Baptist speaking, right? Make the way straight, right? Getting lined up with God, right? Now, this is different because this one says, prepare a way for the people. Woo!
Come on.
Not prepare a way for the Lord, but prepare a way for the people. There's a different outlook in this, okay? Where the first one is the Lord coming through, this one is when the people come through. Because the people need a way to walk, right? Remember, repair the breach, restore the path. Repair the breach, restore the path, right? The path on which we dwell in, right? This is the same essence. This is the same standard. He wants us to build up the highway, okay? Build up. You know what build up means? Work. Right?
Right.
Build up. Build up. Build up. Don't tear down. Build up. Build up. Don't tear down. We've already torn down, right? Things have been torn down, right? Now it's time to build. Build up. Twice. Build up the highway. Why? So that people can start walking. Isn't that good?
Man. I'm glad to be your leader.
I'm telling you guys. Listen, it's time to walk, right?
Come on.
It's time to run.
Yeah.
But if we get this highway, Miss Hope, going, man, this we can get in an automobile. Whoa! Am I right?
Come on.
The highway's for the automobiles. You don't want to travel down the road, you know, on a highway. Well, you can. You can walk down the highway. But here in this state, it's illegal, right?
Yeah.
You can get ran over.
Mm-hmm.
You can't even take your horse down it. Okay? A highway's made for one thing. Quick access. Amen? Quick access. Now, you can go down a country road, a county road, and even a city road on your bike, on a horse, on your feet, right?
Right, right.
But when it comes down to the highway, you need to have only one thing, and that's a motorized vehicle, right?
Mm-hmm.
But you can't get there from here until you start building up the thing that you need to do. Amen?
Come on.
There's a process. Now, in building up, he also says, take out the stones. Okay? Take out the rocks. Listen, rocks are not good. Amen?
That's right.
Man.
I don't know of any place, especially on I-85, if you guys go down far enough towards Greenville, they're taking out the whole road. Everything is being destroyed. And I talked about this a while back. This was done back in 91, okay? I was there. My wife and I were next door, like a block away from where this new highway was coming in. And they're tearing down and breaking up and taking out the rocks and doing all kinds of stuff. And I'm telling you, it was pretty when it was all said and done. It was pretty. But after 25, 28 years, you know, it goes by. You know, you guys have been down to 85, right? After a while, they resurface, patch, right? I'm just saying it. After a while, it starts getting bumpy. And here these guys are not slowing down. I know the speed limit says 70 miles an hour, but they're going 85 because it says I-85. and it's not getting any easier, right? And so what they planned to do was scrap everything, demolish everything, and repave everything from the ground up. That's what this means here. Build up. What you listen, it ain't good enough just to patch it up anymore. Amen. Have you guys ever had a patched up life? Hello? Is it really working just to get a patch here and a patch there?
No.
When you know everything else is still crumbling? You guys understand. Mm-hmm. I don't think that's God's design, is to have you with a patched up life. Mm-mm. It's not good enough to have patches. Even Jesus said, if you want the new wine, you're going to have to get rid of the old wineskin. Amen?
Amen.
And get some new wineskins. Because the old patches ain't gonna work. Right? It's the same process. Listen, I don't know what God is speaking to you about right now, but I'm telling you the truth. I was not planning on speaking this message. I had another message, but God commanded me to speak this message because there are people who have got patched up lives and God wants you to rebuild.
Amen?
Amen.
It's time to take away the old. Completely. Listen, this is a new era.
Man.
You can't do what they had done back in the day. Technology even tells you that you can't take the same phone that your grandma had, that your great-grandma had. You can't use the same phone anymore because technology has made those things desolate. Am I right?
Yeah. Come on.
I'm telling you the truth.
Yep.
It's coming to a time where what was old was old. Uh-huh. We got to step into the new. Go through the gate. Go through the gate. It's time to put the past behind us. Amen? It's time to put the past behind us.